Today's question comes from James Turnham, who's asked us how you paint the power armor of Emperor's Children Chaos Space Marines. So today we're going to show you how to do that, focusing on the pink aspects of their armor. Now the first thing you need to do is undercoat your miniature, and we recommend you use Chaos Black for these, but then it's important you paint them entirely with Abaddon Black. And the reason for this is because Chaos Black and Abaddon Black have different finishes to them. So if you need to neaten up any mistakes, you will notice the difference between these two blacks if you don't paint all with Abaddon Black first. And I have done that in our example miniature, and now we're going to start painting the pink parts. To do this, first of all, you want to base coat all these areas using Ceramite White, and then we're going to layer over those with Emperor's Children. After that, we'll shade the recesses with Caribou Crimson, and then add a highlight of Screaming Skull. But starting out with Ceramite White, I'm going to apply this with a medium layer brush for lots of control here, because what you want to do is just pick some of the panels and basically block them in. So what you want to do is thin your paint down with a little bit of water so it's nice and smooth, like this, and when you're ready, it's just a case of picking whichever panels you want. Now, a great example one will be the faceplate, which is what I'm going to do here, and what I want to do is just start painting in this area all around that trim, just being as neat as I can. Now, with this colour, you will need to apply two thin coats before you move on to the next step, just to ensure that the next pink stage is going to be really bright. Once you're happy with picking out those white panels, what you need to do is apply a layer of Emperor's Children over each of them, and this will give you a really bright pink. Again, you want two thin coats and be as neat as you can around all that black. Now we're ready to give that pink a bit more depth by applying a recess shade of Caribou Crimson on all the recesses around it. Once you've applied the shade, neaten up any mistakes that may have been made, and then you're ready to apply a highlight of Screaming Skull, and you want to apply a fine edge highlight here as neatly as possible. With that highlight applied, the pink details are now complete, and all you need to do is highlight all the black details, for which a great colour to use is Eschen Grey. But James, I really hope that's answered your question, and we'll see you all again very soon.